EM says used to tithe on net income, but I realized I was giving Uncle Sam his cut before the Lord. Now I pay tithes on my gross income. I do not wait for anything, still blessed. Yeah, you know, that's something that I think I struggled with for a little while. Now, percentage-wise, when I first started my business, I was giving off of what was left over in cash flow because that's what was left over. Then, as I began to read more and understand Old Covenant, Tithe 10, New Covenant, it's still Tithe 10, but now it has to be from the heart. And if you've got a problem with your brother, you got to settle that. Or if you got a problem with this, or if you're not feeling it from the heart, God doesn't want your money if it's not coming from the heart. So there's these little, I don't want to say it became a gray area, but I'll hear certain messages that kind of confuse the heck out of me. But I've gotten to a point now where I just tithe more than the percentage of the standard 10%. And I do relate it to gross and also net to see does the gross, based off gross, did I do 10% or more? So in 2020, I did 464,000. I gave more than 10% of that number. In 2019, I did 283,000. I want to say that I gave about 30,000. So a little bit above 10 total. 2018, when I was making 35,000 as my salary income, and I made about an extra 10K when I started the business from July, August, when I started YouTube channel, I gave based off of cash flow. So if I in 2018, I think I made about 35, maybe 40K. I know I did not give more than 4,000 in that year, because I know the first 6 months out of the year, I was not giving anything. It wasn't until I started a YouTube channel, got fired at my job, and I was like, whoa, I gotta start living this kingdom life. Because that's around the time when I got exposed to really more biblical principles on money, kingdom, Miles Monroe, and other influencers that were talking kingdom and providing these principles. So I needed to make up for time, but I know I didn't get anywhere near like 4 or 5 thousand in giving that year. I know there's scripture that talks about making up, right? If you don't give in this year because you had a bad season, you still give 10% plus 10% in the second year, so you give 20 for that year. That's a good method. I think that's a good method if you are trying to build and you're like living in the state of California, the government's taking 50%, whether you like it or not. Like in that comment, most people that get paid, they already took their cut, the government. So technically, the government gets paid before God because they're taking it out of your check to start with. So, bomb, they got their cut. Now you have to live, pay your debts, tithe, save, give. So which columns get sacrificed? It's a very tough decision to make. Some people will sacrifice saving, they'll sacrifice investing, and they'll still give. Some people will have a sit down with God, the Father, the Holy Spirit, Jesus, and say, listen, I need to build this business. I'm going to do it in your name. Give me 3 years. Whatever I make in those 3 years, I'm going to take the gross number, times it by 10%. By the fourth year, I pay you back, God, 30%, not 10. So I do 10, 10, and 10. That's 30. Year four, I give 40% lump sum back to the kingdom and then keep the rhythm going. Keep it over 10% the following years, because by the fourth year is no longer an issue for you to give 10%, regardless of how much the kingdom of the United States takes from us, depending on what state we're in, right? So that is a very interesting thing to consider, depending on what financial situation you are in. Don't beat yourself up. If you're a kingdom citizen, you're not giving 10%. Do not beat yourself up, right? Pray about it. Discuss with people. Have conversation. Figure out ways that you can give alternatively than money. Is it time? Is it resources? Is it energy? Is it focus? Is it attention, right? Listening. What are some other ways that you can do to kind of make up for that? Because time is money, right? And if that's true, then can that substitute if I'm broke and not making anything to begin with, right? So some really good things to think on.